Hi friends, welcome to cricksub.com and today we are going to discuss the match between the teams which started the IPL 2020, that was between Mumbai Indians and Chennai Super Kings. So the inauguration match of the IPL 2020 was held between this match and everybody was looking forward to that match, and the Chennai Super Kings turned out to be the winner in that match one of IPL 2020. So the Chennai Super Kings started their campaign on high. Everybody was thinking, their fans were thinking that they will have a similar season as they had in the last IPL. In the history of IPL, they have been a stronger team, the team which is very difficult to defeat. So, but little did they knew that this season is going to be different altogether. The team is not right there, the performance is not right there, and they are going to have a very miserable, forgettable season that they will not want to remember in their career, the players in their career. So the match was between Mumbai Indians and Chennai Super Kings. The teams fighting again, and this time the Chennai Super Kings got a big defeat. A defeat not by 2, 3, 4, 5 wickets, a defeat by complete 10 wickets. So CSK won a match in this series by winning 10 wickets, and when Shane Watson and Faf du Plessis both made 80 plus runs. But this time they were on the other side of the things as their team was defeated by 10 wickets. So we will quickly take you through about what happened in the match. CSK started batting first, and batting first in the Sharjah is like a dream come true for the captain. So the MS Dhoni was very happy at this moment. So MS Dhoni has told in the post-match presentations that IPL is already over for them. It's very difficult to get into the playoffs. Mathematically it was possible before this match, but the MS Dhoni doesn't believe on that much of mathematical calculations. So he was already of the impression, he gave that impression that they will be, the IPL 2020 is over for them, and they will try experimenting from the next match. So this match they gave Rituraj Gaikwad, who played two matches, and I think he has not made any run so far, maybe one or two runs. In this match they gave him the chance, and Jagdishan, who played a good innings, kind of 33 runs before he was replaced again by Kedar Jadhav, he was back again in this match. So Imran Tahir, who was carrying drinks, he was also featured as a regular 11 member part of the team. So CSK started batting first, but the situation, the batting went downhill from the first over. Rituraj Gaikwad was the first one to dismiss, then Du Plessis, then Raidu, then Jagdishan, and in a matter of a few overs, in just 4 overs, there were 4 wickets, 4 players of the CSK were already back in the dugout, and Dhoni and Ravindra Jadeja had a tough task against them. So Dhoni also, unlike previous seasons, he is also not in his prime, because we have so many times we have seen that a batting collapse happens in the international cricket when he used to play, that Dhoni just put a full stop to that batting collapse. He will rebuild the innings with whatever the players are left, and he will carry the team to a respectable total, but not this time, as the collapse continued. Dhoni was out making 16 for 16, Ravindra Jadeja was out, and then if not for Sam Curran's half century, of 52 runs, the situation could have been worse. But in overall, CSK was able to make just 114 runs, and Mumbai Indians knew that the game is in their pocket. So Mumbai Indians made the most of this small score, and since Rohit Sharma was unwell and Kieran Pollard was captaining, was a stand-in captain, so there was change in the opening partnership. Ishan Kishan came in to bat with the Quinton de Kock, and both remained not out. Ishan Kishan being the more aggressive, he has already hit 99 runs in this IPL, and he made 68 runs. Quinton de Kock continuing his good form, remaining he remained not out on 46, and that made ensure that Mumbai Indians get to that score without losing a wicket, and that means Mumbai Indians won by 10 wickets, CSK losing by 10 wickets, and the worries, the pain for the CSK players is just getting bigger and bigger per match, whatever match they are playing. So CSK is not seeing a change of fortune, not a change in any result. They are just getting defeated match after match. So today also not a very good day for CSK fans. Mumbai Indians, on the contrary, on the other side, they performed really well in the absence of their captain Rohit Sharma. So that's all for today's match. Do let us know in the comments, where do you think CSK lagged in this IPL? In this particular match, what do you make out of the CSK team, where they lagged? Because the Sharjah pitch is like a batting paradise, and they should have at least scored 180 runs, but they just was able to make 114 runs. So that was all from today's match. Dhoni in the post-match presentation, that was a very detailed interview happened in the post-match presentation, and the reporter asked that it's been tough for Mahendra Singh Dhoni also, because he has seen his team going through a great time in the past season. So a lot of questions, a lot of direct questions to Mahendra Singh Dhoni, and Mahendra Singh Dhoni responded very nicely to those questions. But the result is that CSK is now mathematically out of the IPL 2020. So no CSK is in the top 4. We are not going to see CSK in the semi-finals or final in this time, and that is a change, a major change we will be seeing from the last season. So a new team, a new teams will be competing for the final spot. RCB is in the race, Mumbai Indians, Delhi Capitals, and one team is going to be there. Rajasthan Royals is out, CSK is out, so it's between Kolkata Knight Riders, Kings 11 Punjab, Sunrisers Hyderabad are fighting for that place. So that's all for today. Please like, subscribe and share if you like the content, and also press the bell icon if you want to receive the latest notifications of the videos we upload the seconds after. So that's all for today. Stay healthy, stay safe, and keep watching cricket.